Hello, baseball fans, and welcome. We've got a perfect night for baseball on the show. It's the Minnesota Twins going up against the Kansas City Royals. And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this. Just about ready to roll here. Getting the nod in this one, Cole Reagans. What should we keep an eye on here?
Anytime you have five pitches to work with on the mound, that repertoire can be a real weapon in terms of keeping hitters off balance, man. It's one of those things that I'm going to be looking for in this one. Does he have a feel for all of those pitches, or is he just able to get one or two over in the strike zone where he wants? Now, it's tough to do to be able to command all those pitches, but if he can, he is going to be very tough for the opponent today.
And another ball.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with a 3-1 count.
Fastball for a strike. And it's 3-2.
And boy, that was the pitch. 3-1, you want to be really aggressive on the fastball.
In the air, center field. Isbell racing over to make the catch. Now the lineup for the Twins as constructed by Rocco Baldelli. Austin Martin, the next Twin up to hit. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. Line drive, and that should be extra bases. Now he'll turn for second, and that's a two-bagger.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. Kind of a risky pitch coming inside with the breaking ball like that. You have to bury it. Otherwise, it's not too difficult to get the bat to it like he did that time.
One down. Here's Royce Lewis. Man at second. Swing still in for the K. Chase the fastball up the ladder for strike three.
Bird gets talked about a lot, but a good high fastball in a two-strike situation, it's just become such a problem for hitters in more recent years. But with all of the emphasis by pitchers on developing that spin rate, having a good grip on the baseball, those high fastballs, they kind of look like to the hitter that they're rising, even though they're not, but they're not decreasing in velocity and spin rate, so very difficult to get the barrel on.
Mark at second with two down. Swings and misses, struck him out.
He's in a tough spot, had to make a great pitch, did it, got the strikeout, gets out of the jam. Clearly, he's happy with those results.
And we're back. And towing the slab in this one, number 52.
Four-pitch guy, he's got some options to work with in terms of keeping hitters off balance. So we'll see how he decides to utilize those weapons through this start here and whether or not he's able to mix them all in early or if he wants to hold something back a little bit later, maybe second, third time through the order, and give them something they haven't seen. It's tough when you know a guy's got that in his back pocket. As a hitter, you really have to stay on your toes.
And that one is lifted in the air. Sizing this one up. Puts it away for the out. And here now, the lineup for the Royals. And the key to victory for them here, get their starter some run support early.
Boog, if they can get him that run support early, it's likely the other team folds because they know how dominant he can be once he gets settled in. So put pressure on that other team right away, jump out to a lead early, and a few runs is going to feel like 30.
Next pitch in for a strike, and a count 1-2. One out, base is empty. Bills down, swinging for the strikeout. Couldn't hit the fastball at the knees. Vinny Pasquantino steps in for the Royals. Next offering is downstairs. Two outs.
No,
just
off the
missed. Salvador Perez to bat next. And there's the strike.
Full count.
Hot shot to third. Tosses to first. That is the inning. Royals bats are quiet there. Scoreless after one. And welcome back to the ballpark. And now the first baseman, Carlos Santana. And a pitch. On the ground, right side. And he takes it himself for the out.
Batting fifth, the center fielder.
And now the center fielder. Second inning here, no score. Pitch misses, and now 3-1. Reagans. When you talk about his skill set, he stops teams from getting hits. That's the thing that he's so good at. He's just really difficult to get base hits against. That one finds the zone, and the count's full.
Well, he's got power, and he has a reputation of being a strike thrower. So, to his advantage, he can expand the zone.
Battling here as he fouls it away.
He can throw that fastball slightly above the top of the strike zone to get hitters to chase. He can also break it off because when you're geared up for good velocity, it's hard to stay back. You have to make a decision really early. He's really good hitting the baseball the other way. So credit the pitcher for having him out in front of that pitch. Clearly he had him fooled.
Two outs, base is empty. Jose Miranda, the next twin up to him. So what's the approach from an offensive perspective against a guy that doesn't give up a lot of hits?
I think you just kind of have to lean out over the plate and, you know, take your base. But seriously, you just have to try to shorten up. I think guys choking up on the bat a little bit to have some more bat control, be a little bit quicker, and don't get greedy.
Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout. Twins are set down 1-2-3. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Back here in Kansas City, bottom half of inning number two. And now it'll be the cleanup spot for the Royals. Salvador Perez. He might just be the best hitting catcher in the game today.
Well, Boo, he's so valuable. Does a good job behind the plate, but offensively, he's a middle of the order type of bat, especially when you talk about catchers, and their number one job is to handle the pitching staff and prevent runs. This guy is able to add runs by producing them.
Got him swinging.
Came inside with that two-strike fastball nicely and just punched him up on the inside part of the plate. Couldn't get around on it and catch it out front. Many times if you do, it's a foul ball. And you know, a lot of pitchers, they really don't like working inside with two strikes because they do not want to hit that batter. And when they've got him up against the ropes, got to figure out a way to put him away. Did a nice job right there.
And another ball. One One down, base is empty. And that one got a piece of him.
You know, Boone, there always seems to be that oh-no moment for the pitcher when he's lost control of his pitch. And most of the time, it's right when he lets it go. He knows that it's not headed where he intended it to go.
Righty delivers.
And that's in the dirt. Well, with the amount of pitches that can end up in the dirt, a good secondary lead doesn't have to get away from the
runner on the go. Pitching for a strike. Throw a second, tag, and they got him.
Usually when you see a team try to steal a base in the early innings, it tells you they want to be aggressive on offense, try to force the defense to make plays and slow them down. That's exactly what they did right there. So we'll see if that caught stealing changes the offensive approach moving forward.
And a pitch. That one missed.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
And down on strikes he goes. And it's a three up, three down inning. We'll move to the third with no score. Out of the third inning, and now for the Twins, Matt Wallner. Here's a 2-1. This one in the air, center field. Isbell settles underneath it, makes the catch for the out, and there's one down. Now it's the second baseman, Edouard Julien.
This is a hitter who takes his game to another level, playing at night.
Swing and a ball hit out towards left center field. That one gets down for a hit. So now back to the top of the order.
That ball right there landed in what they call a no man's land, meaning it's not really a spot on the field where you can expect anyone to get to it easily. I mean, it's a tough play going back for the shortstop, but also for the outfielders trying to come in. They got to go a long way as well.
And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
So the lineup flips over. This is Willy Castro. Ground ball left side, could be two. There's one, and that's two. One hit in the inning, but no one left. We head down to the home half of inning number three. No score. Bottom of the inning, and here's the veteran outfielder, Adam Frazier.
Adam Frazier.
The line of the pitch. That one finds the corner, and the count 1-2. Swing and a ball lifted left field. That gets down for a hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
That's a ball that a lot of times you'll see the shortstop or left fielder be able to get to if it hangs up in the air long enough. But right there, it just died and found a way to drop in on the green stuff for base hit.
Now it's Paul DeJong up to the plate. Right through there for a strike. Here comes a pitch, and he chases that one, and that's the first out.
Nice, doubled up with the slider for that punch out. Number four just caught the zone, so as a hitter, you have to protect right there. Great pitch to just expand a little bit more. He got that chase he was looking for. That right there is good pitching.
And now it's Kyle Isbell. The pitch. Here goes the runner. High in the air, out to right. Martin going after it. Martin pulls it in on the run.
The batter number 19, second baseman, Michael
So the batting order turns over. Now here's the leadoff hitter for the Royals, Michael Massey. Two outs. And that's off the inside edge. And a count 2-1. Puts it in the air out towards left center. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And the inning is over. Royals lead one, and we're still knotted at zero. As we go to the top of the fourth, digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Austin Martin.
Martin.
Late on that fastball.
Not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
The lefty fires. Tap dances out of the way of that one.
Well, he might have to look for a different put away pitch right here 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times in this at bat, so might have it timed up and ready for it.
Got him looking. That's a strikeout.
Wow, that's a tough call for the hitter, but the pitcher will take that all day long. Not quite in the strike zone, but he found a spot that the umpire is going to, at least for now, allow him to get that call. So hitters are going to have to make an adjustment, but pitchers are going to learn from those things and really try to exploit them if they can.
Two balls, two strikes.
That one the other way. Steps on first for the out.
Now back. The catcher, Ryan Jeffers.
Ryan Jeffers at the plate. Two down, nobody on. Oh, he doesn't get the call. Two balls and a strike.
One strike.
Two down, nobody on. Top half of inning number four. And here it comes. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout. Nothing doing here for the Twins, and we are still scoreless. And we're back. Now here's Bobby Witt Jr.
When he steps into the batter's box, the comfort level looks so high. It doesn't matter what kind of delivery that pitcher has, what kind of velocity, what kind of secondary stuff. He is so settled in there. He owns the home plate area.
Crushed. Left center field. This one's deep. Forget it. That's worth the price of admission. And they jump ahead in the fourth. It's 1-0.
Exactly the pitch he was looking for, crushes it, and hits it out of the ballpark.
And next up for the Royals, Vinny Pasquantino. Left-hand batter waits. And that's outside.
Part of the order coming through now, and with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
the count 2-1. And a foul ball. Two down. And that one is inside.
Very close pitch there, and that was a big one. Clearly, he thought he got the inside corner on the mound, and he's showing his frustration a little bit.
And here's a 3-2. And he walked him. And now it's Salvador Perez to the plate. Pasquantino on at first. Nobody out. And a rope into center field. Base hit. Lead runner around second. The throw in. And the throw's offline. Safe at third. MJ Melendez will hit next. The 1-1. Good eye right there.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
Righty to the plate. That one misses, and that's ball three.
This is a situation where the hitter is looking for something up in the zone that he can get his arms extended. What you have to be careful of is that pitch that's up, that's in on your hands. That'll pop you up in the infield, and that's exactly what the pitcher wants.
Line drive. Fair ball. In comes the runner from third, and they take a two-run lead. Now the throw comes in. Runner holds at third.
Well done. Drives in the run. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
Here's Garrett Hampson. Right-hander kicks, deals. Breaking ball inside. Ball three.
Well, he's so good about trying to drive the ball to the opposite field gap in these situations. If he takes that approach, he could bust this game wide open.
And the pitch. The Royals trying to break this one open. We're here at the bottom of the fourth. One runs in. The throw home. In there safely. And they lead by four.
Oh, that's a big at bat coming through in the clutch to drive in a pair. Just a really nice approach to shoot that line drive to the opposite field. There's a lot of hard work and discipline that goes into getting a result like that at the plate. Doesn't come naturally for most hitters.
No outs. Runner at first. Here's Adam Frazier. The pitch. Late that time, and it's strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
Nobody out, runner at first.
Let's go now, maintain here.
Pickoff throw, Hampson back in standing.
Base runner with a one-way lead right there. All he's trying to do is get a look at the pitcher's move. Had no intent of stealing on that pitch.
And he deals. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Chased the fastball up the ladder for strike three.
Thought it was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
And the right-hander deals. Runner on the move. Still only one out here in the inning. kick. Sandios swings through that one. It's a strikeout.
Well, that's the moneymaker right there. Two strikes, slider down and away from a same side thrower as the hitter. I mean, that's just tough. You're looking to protect with two strikes and very difficult to lay off.
Next pitch way upstairs.
Well, a really rough inning out there on the mound. And this is one of those where you learn a lot about a guy's toughness and his ability to turn the page and keep pressing forward.
Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. Rings it in, and that is that. So four runs on four hits, no errors, and a runner left on. We're headed to the fifth. It's the Royals 4 and the Twins nothing. We go to the top of the fifth, and now it's the switch hitter, Carlos Santana. Liner, and that should be extra bases. And that rolls into the corner. Around first and hustling for second. And he's there with a leadoff double.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there. Could be a chance here for them to start clawing back into this ballgame.
Here's the center fielder. Man at second. Here's a high fly ball out to center. Coming on. He's there. He's got it. And there's one down.
Now back. Designated hitter, Jose Miranda.
So up next, Jose Miranda.
Let's go, Royals!
One out and a runner at second. And we're at the top of the fifth. Lace down the line. This looks like extra bases. Around third. Throws to second. He pulls into second. A run comes in on the play.
That's a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front and ripped it into the outfield, that's one of those swings where you just don't even feel the ball hit the barrel. That's a pure stroke.
Runner at second. Matt Walmer, the next Twin up to hit. The pitch. That's ripped, and this one could be extra bases. Headed for the plate. He scores, and now just a two-run deficit. Around second now, going for three. And he's got an RBI triple.
Picks himself up an RBI. So much of good hitting is finding holes in the defense. That's why you're always thinking line drive into the gap. Those kinds of swings really boost your confidence.
Third with one gone. Now it's going to be Edouard Julien. And the pitch. Up the middle, Massey. Now two away as they get a run across.
Showing us right there why he's considered one of the best middle infielders in the sport. That's always a tough play going up the middle on the backhand. But what really made this play happen was that quick release, smooth exchange, and that was as smooth as it gets. And it had to be with the wheels going down the line.
Now here is Willie Castro. Next pitch is outside. Two outs. Swing and a line drive and a base hit up the middle. So two down, and stepping in is the speedy Austin Martin. The pitch. Runner takes off. Swing and a high fly ball down the right field line. And that should be extra bases. Around third. He scores to tie it up. It's 4-4.
The bat. The third baseman. Royals. Miller.
And it's scoring position with two away. And next for Minnesota, Royce Lewis. Kicks and fires. And it's really to miss there.
As a pitcher, you know the runner on second is ready to push things with his speed. A base hit's probably going to be a big run, so you really have to execute on the mound.
In the air, right field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And that's the third out. So they get four in the inning and have it evened up again. Home half of the fifth coming up. And we are tied 4-4. Back now to start the bottom of the fifth and taking over on the mound, number 73.
Well, they didn't get much length out of their starter in this one, so they've got a lot of outs to eat up in that bullpen. I think they'll look for some length out of him right here if they can get it.
Michael Massey steps in for the Royals.
The second baseman, Michael Massey.
Left-hand hitter waits. And a foul ball. One, two now. Swing and a miss. That one in the dirt. Throw to first. In time to get him. One away in the strikeout. And to the plate for Kansas City, Bobby Witt Jr. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. Base is empty, one away. Last half of inning number five. Base hit, center field.
Well, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride low, out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee. And now let's see if they force some action with good wheels on the bases.
Runner on at first with one gone. So up now for runner on the go. That's in for a strike. Safe at second with a stolen base. That was close, but StatCast shows us why he so often seems to be on the safe side of these steal attempts, Chris.
Yeah, you see that plus speed, and he needed every last bit of it to swipe that bag. Such a threat on the bases.
Runner edges away at second. Foul ball still, one and two count. Right-handed reliever. That one misses. Now 2-2. Trying to get him to chase on the changeup that time. Salvador Perez next up for Kansas City. And a pitch. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Tied at 4. And he hits a ground ball right side. Throws to first in time. So they get the out after a long battle at the plate.
Not a bad outcome in that spot. The runner moves up to third, and now they have a chance to drive in the go-ahead run. It's not a knock, but at the end of the day, it's a good at-bat.
Now it'll be the cleanup hitter for the Royals, Salvador Perez.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
And a count 1-2. Oh, Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. Runner from third in to score. And it's now 5-4.
Well, there you go. The RBI machine. Another clutch run scoring at bat.
Yeah, he's been so good in these situations. Call it clutch if you want, but his resume speaks for itself. MJ Melendez steps in for the Royals. The pitch. Swing and a miss. And the count is 1-2.
1-2.
Perez leads off first with 2 down to the inning. Goes down looking. Well, they pick up one run on the RBI single. It's now a 5-4 ball game. It's Major League Baseball, and it's on the show. All right, we go to the top half of inning number 6. And now the catcher comes up to hit. Brian Jeffers. And a pitch. Movement in the bullpen, Carlos Hernandez, the young right-hander, up and throwing. Long, also getting ready. Hawaii to kick the pitch. Fights that one away, still 1-2. This one in the air. And there's one down. Now Carlos Santana, the next twin up to hit. So right-handed slugger at the plate. Chrissy is surprised that the lefty is still in there.
Extremely. I mean, you've got arms down in the bullpen, and there's somebody down there that can match up, try to get out of this jam.
The Royals leading by a run, and we're the top half of the 6th. Not even close there. 3-2 now. Inside ball 4.
It's tough after falling behind a hitter, 2 balls and no strikes, but now at least he gets a fresh start against a new batter. But he needs to get back into the strike zone and start pitching with conviction.
Here comes the skipper, and we're going to see a pitching change in this spot. Cole Reagans departs, and he leaves in a 1-run. New pitcher coming up. We'll be back in a minute. Sam Long into the game.
And this is an important part of this game. Tight score and still a lot of outs to get. So they're looking for a big outing out of him right here to get some critical outs.
Man at first with one gone. And now the center fielder. In the dirt. And an excellent job keeping it right there. Here comes a pitch. Late on that fastball.
Man, he was really tardy on that fastball. Great job of setting him up by throwing the curveball. Add some velocity to it on the next pitch. Can't catch up.
Gets a piece. And stays alive. That misses. And a full count now.
Well, on this count, runner not known for his speed, but I think you got to put him in motion. Try to avoid a double play here, Boop.
At the belt and fires. And it's ball 4. He missed down low.
Pretty much the last thing you want from your bullpen arms are free passes, especially in spots like this. Make the team earn their way.
Jose Miranda digs in now. This is what stat nerds like myself might call a high leverage situation.
Yeah, Pogue, not sure what the numbers say, but clearly an at bat that could change the course of this game dramatically.
On the ground, right side. Could be extra bases. Headed for the plate. One runs in. Another comes drives in to score. They've got the lead 6-5.
He has had such a good day today. I think he's going to want to leave when it's over.
A couple of doubles today for the DH. Matt Walmer now at the plate. Ball to strike. The pitch. Swings through that one for strike two. A 1-2. And another ball. One out and a runner at second. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
Up next,
Edouard Julien, the next twin up to him.
The way these two teams have battled in this game, you know you need more. Got to continue to add runs if you're going to get out of here with a win.
Just missed. And a 2-1 on the way. On the ground at first, and it goes just foul. Down the line. Nobody can get there, and it's a foul ball. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Ball. And downstairs.
Full count.
Willie Castro waits on deck. Swing and a miss, and that is that. But they'll pick up a couple runs here, both coming on this two-run double. And the home team down a run. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Bottom of the sixth. Stepping in, Garrett Hampson. This is a guy you got to keep an eye on when he digs in. Definitely been known to drop a drag bunt from time to time, and he's pretty good at it, Chris.
Yeah, and he creates a sense of urgency for the defense because of the speed, because of the ability to put down that bunt.
Off the mark there, and that's ball two. Now you see even sluggers from time to time try and use the bunt really as a way to beat the shift. And now it's filled up. Good plate appearance there, able to take the walk.
Well, that right there could end up being a big walk in this game. He's certainly a threat on the bases, especially with them looking to tie this thing up.
No outs, runner at first. Adam Frazier getting ready to hit. Trying to move him over here. Over to first, too late. The sack bunt turns into a single.
This couldn't have played out any better on offense. They were trying to trade it out to move the runner into scoring position, but instead, they just couldn't make the play on defense. You really need to get an out there.
So digging in, Paul DeJong. And here it comes.
Ball.
That one is upstairs.
Three ball, one strike.
Offering in there for a strike. And the count's full. Payoff pitch. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. First and second here, no outs. Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. And the righty deals. Foul ball, and it remains a full count.
Ready for that fastball right there. It really turned on it, hit it hard, had the distance, but just too much hook to it. So it might want to make a little bit of an adjustment, let it travel a little more, and see if you can keep that thing fair.
Drilled to right, way back there, and that is gone. A three-run dinger. It's 8-6. He kept swinging, and it paid off.
Well, that was a battle, Boog, and he just kept taking his cuts. Finally squared one up. That's just a great feeling as a hitter. You let the ball travel, tracked it pretty nicely. He's almost beat there, but he gets the bat head in time, and it's true.
Cole Sands gets the call from the pen.
Now, just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
Next to hit, Kyle Isbell. And a pitch. He swings and fouls one off. Left-hand batter waits. Got him looking. One down.
The batter number 19.
So the Royals batting order turns over. Here's the second baseman, Michael Massey. Already three runs across in the frame here in the bottom of the sixth. There's a strike. Some movement in the Twins bullpen. Number 60 getting loose out there. Alcala warming up as well. One down, base is empty. Fouls it off, still 1-2. So a man aboard now with one away.
He was all over that one. Other than ripping one into the gap or blasting one over the wall, there aren't a whole lot of hits that are more satisfying than a nice line drive in the center field. So that definitely felt good.
Rudder takes off. On the ground to third. Tosses across to first. No chance at the double play with the runner in motion.
Number nine. Ready.
And here's the first baseman, Vinny Pasquantino. The 1-1. Hit in the air, left field. Walner under it. And that is that. Royals grab three on this homer. It's now 8-6. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on the show. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Carlos Hernandez.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect a tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
And now the shortstop, Willie Castro.
Willie Castro.
And he deals. That one fouled off. Swing and a miss. Some high by Keys for strike three. A big first out here in the seventh via the punch out.
Yeah, it just does so much to change the outlook of an important inning like this. When you got the leadoff hitter, so critical in setting the table when you got a tight game like this. So a strikeout really puts them on their heels.
Austin Martin, the next twin up to hit. And misses inside. The pitch. Line drive, base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Clearly seeing the ball very well in this one. He clearly didn't catch that one on the big part of the bat. Just kind of muscled it out there. And on the mound, it can be pretty frustrating for a pitcher, but you just kind of have to expect those to drop in there sometimes. And now a chance to maybe get creative on offense with good speed on first.
One down. Royce Lewis, the next twin up to hit. And another ball. With the tying run at the plate here in the top half of inning number seven. Swing and a miss. And the count is 2-2.
The two strikes may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
Next pitch misses. Full count 3-2. Ryan Jeffers next to bat for Minnesota. Tying run at the plate. He fouls it off. We'll do it again. Outside, and that is ball four.
A great back and forth in that at bat. He had to play off some really close pitches, and somehow, Boogie found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
New pitcher in the game for the Royals, Chris Stratton.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves, late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
First and second, one out. Now the cleanup hitter for Minnesota, Ryan Jeffers.
Definitely wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball on the ground in the infield. Should be an inning-ending double play.
So the tying run at second.
Well, no, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning. It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
Righty delivers.
That's a ball.
That one misses, and that's ball three. Carlos Santana in the on-deck circle for the Twins. Martin, the lead runner at second. Lewis over at first with one away. Next offering in there for a strike. Three balls, two strikes. Right-hander kicks, deals, cracks his bat, and pops him up. So first and second with two outs. So up next for Minnesota, Carlos Santana. Yeah, a 2-1 hammered but foul.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
Strikeout.
Well, needed a big strikeout to get out of danger. Turned to the deception, that changeup. Great execution. Really sold it with the arm speed. Had his opponent way out on that front foot.
bottom of the seventh. And here's the catcher, Salvador Perez. The pitch. Fly ball down the line. And that's a foul ball. That one back up the middle and it gets through.
The left fielder, number one, MJ.
Man at first, here's the left fielder, MJ Melendez. And the pitch. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2.
A healthy cut. Tough pitch at 98, but a really good pass at the ball.
Good job to fight that one off. The pitch. Hit in the air, right field. Martin snags it.
Lefties can definitely be a little pull happy up there, especially with pitches that they see pretty well. That was a good example. He hooked an outside pitch, hit that ball in the air to right, just not with much authority.
And now the DH, Garrett Hampson. Strike two.
Well, that's that slope right there. He threw it extremely well. Talk about just a ton of break. So tough to get that barrel to.
Got him swinging. Couldn't catch up to the heater.
Really nice execution of the cut fastball right there. Similar to how you might throw a two-strike slider. Start at middle away and let it break and take over that outside corner of the plate. But sometimes with a cutter, you just don't know how much it'll move. I think he's good, but I think he was also a little lucky right there.
So two down now, and here is Adam Frazier. Out towards left center. Touches down. That's a hit. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out. On the mound now for the Twins, Jorge Alcala.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
Alcala.
And the batter now, Paul DeJong. He's been a difference maker in this one with what he did back in the sixth.
No doubt, Boog, a huge three-run homer, and it's one of the key moments in this game.
Two on, two outs. On the line, base hit. Rounds third, headed for the plate. Now a long throw home, and he's out. Up down, and that ends the inning.
Well, it's pretty difficult to throw a base runner out at the plate with two outs on a base hit to the outfield, but an excellent job of coming up with it, getting rid of it quickly, and throwing on the money. That is great technique from start to finish. Nice job to end the inning.
Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. John Schreiber.
Now pitching for the Royals. Number 46. John Schreiber.
Here's the center fielder. Left-hand hitter waits. And that one is lifted in the air. Melendez drifts towards it, and there's one down.
Now back.
Now it's the Twins DH, Jose Miranda. The Twins trailing by two, and we're at the top of the eighth. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two. Activity in the Kansas City bullpen. Lucas Ayrson, the closer of the staff, is throwing. MacArthur also throwing. Just missed.
And that's awfully close. I don't know how you take that. He's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well right now.
Got him looking for the strikeout. Strike three called and a slider at the knees.
Well, this is no secret. That slider is going to be his go-to pitch. Everyone in the ballpark knows it. It's a massive part of his arsenal, and he'll throw it a lot and in pretty much any count, any situation, and he's going to look to punch guys out as well. I tell you what, the effectiveness of that slider is always a big key for him.
Now a chance for Matt Wallner. Foul ball.
All sliders so far in this at bat to get ahead in the count, and clearly shows there was a game plan in mind for how to attack him in the box.
Swing and a high fly ball out there towards left field. Makes the grab, and that'll do it. And welcome back to the ballpark. Ready for the bottom of the eighth. And the batter now, Kyle Isbell. You talk about elite defensive players, especially in the middle of the diamond, and this guy is at the top of the list. And now 2-1.
Yeah, we go beyond just the fielding percentage and what it looks like, but the ability to have range and close holes that are normally there against an average defender. But this guy is special, and you can see it in his first step quickness.
And that one is in for a strike.
Logan, the one thing about that is speed never goes in a slump, and defense shouldn't either. Hitting-wise, you can struggle, you can lose your mechanics, but the thing that you can do consistently every single game is play great defense if you're talented in that way, and this is what this guy does.
That one misses, so a leadoff walk.
Well, that could be a tone setter for the inning. Four straight pitches and the leadoff batter is on base. We'll see if the next guy waits until there's a called strike before he takes the bat off the shoulder.
Michael Massey, the next to hit. Kicks and deals. 3-2 now. Isbell aboard here at first with nobody out. And ball four, two aboard.
Well, interesting. He went with the off speed and walked the hitter. Maybe going to challenge the guy with the fastball.
And now here is Bobby Witt Jr. singing. He's a guy that covers both sides of the plate about as well as anyone in the sport. How difficult is that to do?
Well, just look at the back of my bubblegum card. You'll see how hard it is. These guys are great, man. They have the ability to look out there, but also to be able to turn on the inside pitch. Those that can really sharpen things on the outer half, those are the ones that become elite.
Vinny Pasquantino steps in for the Royals. Two on, one out. Little chopper rolls foul. The pitch. Swings and lines a base hit into left field. Fires it to the plate. It's off the mark and he scores.
Big at bat to pad their lead up to three. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. Hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
First and second, one out. And now it'll be the cleanup spot for the Royals. Salvador Perez and a pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. And the right-hander deals. And another ball. And a pop-up. Right side, foul territory. Santana hauls it in, and there's two away.
The left fielder, number one, MJ.
So first and second with two outs. MJ Melendez steps in for the Royals. The 1-2. And there's a ball. Two outs. Just missed.
Full count.
Swings and misses. Good job at damage control right there. But the RBI single pushes across a run. Last chance coming up for the Twins. Now, and on the mound, the closer, Lucas Ayrson.
I think closer has to be one of the toughest jobs in baseball, and we see a pretty high turnover rate because of it. Every outing seems to be high pressure, this one included. We'll see if he can wrap up the win and get himself a save.
Hits and misses. It's a strikeout.
Now, there's a small sigh of relief right there. I mean, just to keep that speed off the base pass. It's not just the pitcher. It's other guys that have to think about it. From your infielders, have to think about that runner potentially stealing, but also be in position to make a play. As an outfielder, you're thinking about a base hit to the outfield. I got to get to it quickly to try to keep this guy from taking an extra base. So I think everyone just a little more relaxed that he didn't reach base.
The Royals trying to close out a three-run lead here at the top of the ninth. One down, base is empty. Foul ball still, a 1-2 count. Kicks and fires.
Ball two.
Still just the second batter of the inning, and on the mound, he's already thrown 13 pitches. They got him working hard out there.
Here comes a pitch. Right side, hard hit. Over to first. That was a strong at bat, even though he couldn't find a way on base. The Twins down to their final out. Austin Martin, the next Twin up to hit. This could end it. That's to third. Slides for the stop. Gathers and throws. And one play. Ball game.
Well, this was a total team effort using six pitchers in this ballgame to get the win. Outstanding job of passing the baton, the next pitcher stepping up and getting it done. You got to give them a lot of credit because this is not easy to do. We'll see how it affects them over the next couple of days.
9-6 the final in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Shalvey saying so long.
First for the victorious Kansas City Royals, 9 runs, 14 hits. No errors. They left 8 runners on base.